Bumblebee Danny, nice to meet you.
Alan, I'm playing Optimus Prime.
You're Optimus Prime!
Take it easy. I get this a lot.
Oh, my gosh. Second favorite character.
What's cool is the script provides, you know, so much of it for you. You know, who, like any role, you know, who they are is, you know, not just what they say and what they do, but the way people talk about them. And Optimus Prime is obviously the same Optimus Prime that's been in all these other iterations. He's the leader, you know. He's a general. He's the leader of his species here on Earth. And, you know, he's made some tough decisions. And he continues in this series to make difficult decisions for the betterment of not just his own species, but for Earth and for humans. And so, you know, he's historically been a bit stoic, you know. He's that kind of guy, but he's a little bit more lively here. You know, he's playing with that cone. I love that, those little touches that you guys have. Like you know, Optimus Prime can have a day where he can't even pick up a cone. And you know, he's very large. He's a big truck, and that makes, you know, the voice becomes a little bit deeper, and he talks. We found early on, like, if he talks too fast, it kind of it doesn't work as well, you know, because he's big. He takes up a lot of space, so he has a very deliberate way of talking, and so he's used to being listened to, and he's a very considerate, good guy, great cook. swell singer. You wouldn't know that about him, but really,
he can hold a tune.
Oh, I feel like he's like a baritone, probably kind of like
very much a baritone.
Yeah, Bumblebee is iconic character. Like I said, a fan, and yeah, there's those two feelings, right? The feeling of excitement to be able to take on this new role, and then also the fear that you're going to destroy the entire franchise with your performance. But it, like Alan said, it starts on the page, you read it, and I was so, like, excited just about this new take. And Bumblebee, in particular, with this role, he is kind of caught in an unsteady position, right? So he's a scout. He is kind of in between the Autobots and the Terrans. And, you know, he's the type of guy who has something to prove. He's got something still to prove, and he's excited. And so there's a lot there I could relate to. But then when we came in, I didn't want to, like, listen to too much or try to go back and try to mimic anything. I wanted to try to see if I could just bring in something new. So, but I had some ideas, and, you know, I came in with these ideas of how to, Bumblebee should be. Should Bumblebee be like this, or should be like this? And then they're like, Danny, just talk normally. It's going to be the best for everyone. And I think we were all relieved. You will be relieved. And that was really exciting and also freeing, because I was able to just bring myself to the role, think about Bumblebee and his new role as mentor, and let that inform my take. And there's just kind of fun aspects about being able to finally make punching noises and heroic poses, and I've never been able to do that. Usually I'm skilled in verbal warfare or holding maps, and this has been a fun new challenge for me.